Creating our homepage. Adding Angular material. In this video, we will add Angular material to the project and create our own material theme. So let's add Angular material. We are going to use another feature of the Angular CLI to add Angular material, the ng-add command. This command adds support for an external library to our project, and in this case, it's the Angular Material library. So let's go ahead and do that. We are greeted by an interactive input prompt. So the first question is what theme we want. So we will select the custom theme since we are going to customize it. Next, we are asked if we want Hammer.js for gesture recognition. Since we are building a mobile-friendly website, it's yes. And last question is about browser's animation. We will answer a yes to. We would have added it either way because we are going to create our own Angular animations in the next sections. Let's have a look at the changes that were done to our project. First, in the package.json file, we can see here that the Angular CDK and the Angular material were added, as well as Hammer.js. Next, the index.html. We can see here that the Roboto font was added, as well as material icons. So we are going to use our font awesome icons and our Montserrat font, so we are going to remove these two lines. So we're going to open the file and delete the two lines that were added. Then main.ts. Here we can see that it's simply importing Hammer.js, so everything is fine. Let's go to the app.module.ts. Here, it's importing the browser animations module and adding it to the imports of our app module. So that's an action that we wanted to, so that's okay. And now the last file that was modified, styles.scss. Let's open it directly. We have matcore first that includes the common styles for Angular material. Then we have the different palettes, primary, accent, and warn. Below we find the creation of the theme, in this case here with a light theme. And finally, all the styles for the Angular material components are added. The first thing we are going to do is take care of moving all of the material styling to its own file. So let's go ahead and do that. Under styles, we're going to create a material.scss file. And then here we can copy the material theme. Feel free to pause the video and read the comments that are displayed here. In my case, I'm going to delete them since I already know the content. The accent color we choose is similar to the teal palette in material, so we are going to use it for the primary. Then blue for the accent. And then we'll leave it as red for the warn. And finally, we are going to switch to the dark themes. So we need to switch the matte light theme to matte dark theme. We can save this. And now we can just import it inside styles.scss. And we are done setting up Angular material.